Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here with a Lego Legends of Chima set. This is Gorzan's Gorilla Striker, set number 70008. This is a 2013 release. It's the second set of 2013 releases for the summer, supposedly. And this is a 505 piece set officially, and it's being reported at $50 for the targeted price in the United States, $50 US, although it's already looking like it's disproportionately more expensive in other markets, including the UK, where it has already been released, and it is £50, which is a good deal more than $50. So that's a little bit odd. Let's go ahead and build this up and take a look at the set. Well, that was actually a pretty fun build with some interesting techniques used in there and some parts that I haven't seen much of, as well as some new parts. So let's take a look at the minifigures first, and I will just move you over here and then pick up and start looking at the individuals. Here we go. Here's one. This is from the Raven tribe. This is Rizzo. And he is the main bad guy of this set. He's the one that you're going up against. You can see he's got a prosthetic leg in this case. A lot of the Raven tribe characters seem to lose their limbs at various times. And he's got a projectile weapon that he's carrying there. And he's actually going to be manning a Raven nest tower, kind of a turret defense unit we'll see in a minute. And then moving on, Gorzan. Well, of course, you got Gorzan in there because it is Gorzan's Gorilla Striker. It is his vehicle. And this is a part that I have not seen before, this large fist piece, and I have not been able to locate a name for this big hammer weapon that he's carrying, but that's pretty cool. And he's got a brown armor piece on the chest. It's got a mix. It's actually dark brown, and got a mix of dark brown and black parts on this one. And then an elder character, an elder gorilla tribe character. This is Grumlo. And you see he's all gray. He's like a silver gorilla in this case, and he's got another of those exact same weapons, and he's got print all the way around him. I'm actually gonna, if you want to see, you know, as always, if you want to see up close pictures of every minifigure thing, I'm not going to take a lot of time to spend time talking about every single thing on there. You can just pause the video, or better yet, you can just go to any of the many excellent resources out there on the web that will show you photographs of the minifigures, and you can also look up weapon details, although weapon details are not yet out, as far as I've seen, for the Gorilla Tribe. I'm going to try to get through these reviews a little bit faster because I seem to get slower and slower and slower with them. This here is the little Grumlo, and she is actually the one who has been taken captive by Rizzo of the Raven Tribe, and you actually need to go in and save her. She's being held captive up in a tree, and you need to take Gorzan's Gorilla Striker into the forest and see if you can rescue her from her captives. That's a nice little small character there with a lot of flower details on there in the print. And these fist pieces, which are also a new piece for the summer 2013 sets. These have only been released in two sets. And those actually are minifigure accessories. They look pretty funny. Okay, now I mentioned that there is a raven nest tower or kind of a turret here, and this is it, and this is where Rizzo would be standing, and it kind of looks like you've got a flying craft right here, but it's actually not supposed to be a flying craft. It's just supposed to be a manned kind of a turret emplacement. I'm not going to go ahead and connect him all the way there because it takes extra time, but that's kind of how that would work out. He would sit there and he can rotate around and he can basically defend this spot. And there is a little bit of sticker action going on back here, so you can see a little bit of some vines and some interesting colored foliage around there. And over on this side, so this is kind of the front right here. And over on this side, there's a small little miniature catapult installation, and they give you four of these fruit pieces. And it's interesting, they went back in time to the old Technic pieces with the ball pieces. That's all this is just a Technic ball piece. You can see normally an axle would go in there. They just stuck a carrot top in it to turn it into a rancid fruit bomb. You assume that this would explode or maybe it would stink or something. I don't know. Not a lot of details about these out there just yet. But these are ammunition that you would put in there, and it sets in there very nicely, actually. And then depending upon how hard you hit this, it'll just shoot it off. That's very effective. And they give you four, so that's nice. Plenty to actually work with. And then, you know, this can rotate around. You've got a couple of shooters on here. I don't know exactly what type of weapons those are, but I'm assuming that they are chi powered, they are energy weapons. And then I will get back to one more piece of activity that can be revealed here, but I want to focus most of my time on the main piece, the main focus of this set. This is Gorzan's Gorilla Striker, and as you can see, it's clearly based on the design of a gorilla. It's got kind of a gorilla face in it, and they actually worked that out really nicely with all this very genuine brick build. It's very nicely built. It's very Lego. You know, they didn't resort to cheap tactics, but it works out really well. Nice angles in here. You got the kind of a really thick brow, and then the large snout of a gorilla. He's got actually a couple of teeth that show up here. You can see that it's actually made with wood. These two pieces right here are stickers, and down here, these metallic round pieces end up kind of looking like he's got a six pack of abs there, so he's really strong. Even though, you know, this is not a living character, this is actually effectively a mech, a large mech. But it does work out nicely. You can see this medium blue color that just really, really shines. You know, it's a much nicer, more contrasty color than the standard blue. And they do use two different colors of brown throughout here. You've got the reddish brown, you've got the dark brown, both of those. This piece here, this half of a curve piece here, was most famously first used on Boba Fett's Slave One in, I think that was 2010, if I'm remembering that right. Not the first one, I don't think it was the second one, I think it was third version of the, or third release of the Slave One. But anyway, I think this is the first time we've gotten this piece in black. That works out well. Hero Factory part used here on the hand, and the hands, you can see that they're actually linked. These are articulated. They do have a ball socket joint here, so you can kind of change the position quite a lot to get a lot of expressiveness out of these hands with the fingers. It's just a brick and plate build of finger. The way these are held on to these Exo-4's arms is just by using a lightsaber blade. And if I can pick this off, there we go. You can see the lightsaber blade right there. It's in reddish brown. And that just goes all the way up through the axle holes in these brick and plate pieces. That works out nicely. You can see the car's trunk is actually hood or bonnet piece is used here. Used here, again on the feet. You do have a little bit of articulation where you can kind of lean him over based on the feet turn that down so you can get some interesting poses out of them, or out of it, make it look like it's actually moving around. You've got a little bit of articulation in the feet by way of a ball and socket joint. And then you can also just move the legs in and out like so. It's not the most stable mech. You do want to be a little bit careful about how you line everything up and make sure that you keep a wide base. It is pretty heavy up top, and these hands are very heavy too, which is part of the reason why I think they didn't make the hands stand up on their own. If they did, it would want to fall forward a lot. I mean, it's probably going to catch itself, but as it is, they've just made those a action piece where you can actually make them move by just turning this knob on the back. So you can see what that would look like from the front, where you can just raise these up and watch out for the fingers actually interfering with the feet. But you can raise them up and you can see that it kind of has a little bit of personality to it, and kind of comes alive a little bit like that. So that's kind of cool. It works out, and I think for a gorilla based design, I think that it makes sense for the hands to be large and to just kind of hang by the side most of the time. It doesn't bother me that you can't easily pose those in an upward position. And then up here you can see you have a cannon also, and this is an old style Technic cannon. These work really, really well. And this can be aimed just about any way because it's on a ball and socket joint here. And you've got a bandolier. Oh, just accidentally shot myself in the arm. Oh, somebody help me, Band-Aid, doctor, something, medic. All right, I'll be okay. Whoa, I need to stop holding it from that spot because it's just gonna keep shooting every time I do that. That's the trigger right there. You pull it back just a little bit and it shoots. These things work great. This is intended to be a rapid fire banana gun. So they actually use fruit, they fight with fruit. We've got all these bananas. So that's kind of a kind thing, you know, gorillas shooting bananas. It's not all that destructive, you know. You can knock things off, but you're not gonna do any real damage. Plus, the ammo is biodegradable, so it's nice to the environment. But there's more that you can shoot. Hidden behind here, behind the mouth, you can actually open up the mouth like so. Open this and you can see that it has a chi power core to it, and these are flick fire missiles. Maybe they are like blueberry stalks or something like that, you know, different fruit, but they look really nice. They look like candy. I like that color in there, actually getting the darker trans blue rather than the light trans blue. But those are flick fire. These are single fire. These are double fire. You can access the firing mechanisms for those, again, from the back. So you kind of have your own personal control center from the back as a player, as an owner of the model. You can control the hands from here. You can fire the cannon from here, and you can do the flick fire missiles by pushing these in quickly. So these are the doubles and these are the singles, and that's how that works. Pretty cool. And the general idea of this entire thing is that it would be piloted by Gorzan. Remember, it's Gorzan's gorilla striker, and he would be standing. This is actually the cockpit up here. This is where he would be. I'm gonna have to get a better view of that from the top. Oh no, there are actually a couple of levers down in here. Not sure if you're really gonna see that, but they're actually control levers, and I accidentally pushed one straight down. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get that back up for this review. I'm just gonna move it off to the side. That's unfortunate, but the idea is that he would be standing here in this spot and operating those control levers. It's a little bit tough to get him in there. Let's see if I can get the right angle and just get him pushed in. There's not a lot of space. There we go. I think I just got it. Turn his headpiece back. There we go. And that's how he would sit in there. Now that's his perch. So just imagine this thing coming at you in the jungle. You know, that's pretty fearsome. That's pretty serious stuff. And then the last thing that I want to show you here, I hinted at it earlier, but a little bit of action that you can get out of this set. You want to try to take this thing down. Shooting at it is going to help. You know, it's kind of use suppressive fire, but the best way to completely take this down all the way is to fight your way up towards the forefront of the battle that's going on. Try to get up close, get one arm out there and see if you can do like this. Let me see if I can line this up right. Nope, not close enough. Not quite getting there. It's not working so well in this case. It's supposed to work. I got it to work previously. There we go. So you see what happened there? It doesn't quite work out as well as it's intended. I got it before, but it's a little bit tough to get all the weight in there. This is actually set up with a release mechanism that's supposed to show when the turret gets destroyed, basically. It gets disabled. This whole thing, if you hit it back here on this branch, hit it hard enough, it all just falls off. There's just a mechanism that just pushes it right on off. So that's what you're going for to really win against this tower. You know, there's a lot of firepower from this single location that's being shot out from here. He's got his hand weapon, he's got his catapult. You want to try to get in close and take it out by hitting the branch to just knock the entire thing off. That's the general idea. It doesn't work out quite as well as expected. You might be able to experiment a little bit and find a perfect orientation of the fingers and some way to get them to put the maximum amount of kinetic energy into that branch to really take it off. So that could be an interesting challenge for you to figure out the best way to take that down. But that does it for this review. Thank you very much for watching. This is Gorzan's Gorilla Striker 2013 set, featuring the talents of Gorzan, and you've got three other minifigures also, set number 70008, and it's a $50 set in the US once it gets released in the US with 505 pieces. Thank you very much for watching. Hope that was enjoyable for you. I had fun with it. Certainly had fun with the build. It's a really interesting build. Really fun to see it come together from many parts, and I hope to have a chance to yak at you again later. Bye for now.